This video shows how to calculate the effect size Cohen's d in the case of an observable interaction for the mixed ANOVA and SPSS. First of all, this is about pairwise comparisons, i.e. whether there are group differences at certain points in time or whether there are differences within groups over time. An effect size should be calculated for the pairwise comparisons that have a sufficiently small p-value. As these are pairwise comparisons, Cohen's d is used, the calculation of which I will now show. Note, I have already shown the calculation of eta squared, whether partial or generalized, which quantifies the strength of the interaction effect itself. There are basically two ways of calculating Cohen's d, depending on the type of pairwise comparison conducted. Let's start with the simpler case. We have a group difference at one or more points in time. This is simply an independent t-test. Go through analyze, compare means and proportions, independent samples t-test. The time points for which differences could be observed are entered in the test variables field. In my example, this would be the case at time points 3 and 5. Finally, make sure that estimate effect sizes is ticked before clicking OK to request the results. The output contains only one table that is relevant for us, independent samples effect sizes. It can be found at the bottom and in my example shows a calculation of Cohen's d and Hedges correction of d for time points 3 and 5 respectively. The difference between the two is marginal. If you are in doubt, both can be reported. See Grissom Kim, page 69. Speaking of reporting, report absolute values for the effect sizes, meaning always positive values. In my example, d is 0.7 in T3 and 1.91 in T5. These effect sizes are then compared and classified with similar studies. Alternatively, research field-specific thresholds can also be used. If neither is available, Cohen 92, page 157 can be used. Having done this, we turn to the somewhat complicated case. Differences over time within a group. Nothing can be observed for the control group, but for the intervention group at time points 1 and 3, 1 and 5, 2 and 5, and 4 and 5. Since the within subjects factor is being analyzed for the intervention group, we have to use paired t-tests to account for those repeated measures. Before starting, a filter must be set, though, to get rid of all individuals who do not belong to the intervention group. To do this, go to Data, select Cases. Then click on If condition is satisfied, and then the if button. The group variable and the filter condition are put in the top right hand field. In my case, group equals 2 because the intervention group is coded with 2. A quick check in the data view should show a crossed out case number for all individuals who are not part of the intervention group. Now for the paired t-test. Go through analyze, compare means and proportions, paired samples t-test. The pairwise comparisons that could be observed are now entered in the corresponding fields. The selection of the standardizer is a tricky decision because the correlation of the measured values at the time points leads to a more or less large correction. Here I recommend following Grissom Kim, page 87-88, and sequentially requesting both the standard deviation of the difference and the corrected standard deviation of the difference. As other studies often only report Cohen's d, but not which standardizer was used, this sometimes results in inconsistent effect sizes. Once again, only the bottom table, paired samples effect sizes, is of interest. I have deleted the non-relevant tables, showing only the calculation based on the different standardizers directly below each other. These effect sizes are also reported as absolute values, meaning positive values. You can see that there are sometimes differences in the effect sizes of up to 0.25. If no similar studies or research field-specific thresholds exist, Cohen 92, page 157 can be used. However, it should be noted that those thresholds refer to the calculation not adjusted for the correlation of the measured values. After all calculations are done, the results are reported, which is shown in the following video.